Hey Lego fans, it's Jang here from JANGBRiCKS with a couple more fire-related vehicle mocks. I've got a brush truck here and a tiller ladder or hook and ladder truck. And these will be the last fire-related vehicle mocks that you'll see from me for a while, I believe, because I think this finishes up my department. And the next fire-related mock that you'll see from me will be my fire station, which has been done for a little while now. So here we go. Let's go ahead and look at the little one first, get that out of the way. Like I said, it's just a brush truck, one of those pickup truck based four-wheel drive, small firefighting vehicles. And I did go with different wheels and tires front to rear so that I have wider tires in the back, which now that I think about it, might not make so much sense for four-wheel drive, but I guess if the diameters are the same, kind of think of this as being a dually setup in the back where it would have two wheels side by side. Put a little bit of extra length on the hood here to make it look a little bit more heavy duty, you know, compared to a typical passenger pickup truck. I think that just helps with the shorter windscreen and a little bit longer hood. I think makes it look just like the type or class of vehicle that I wanted. A little bit of faux detail here for a little bit of cabinetry on the side. It does have a monitor on the top, which can go up and down. It can also rotate around like so. And put that back. And got an axe over here, shovel over here. And then on the back, you do have a hose reel and some more lights back there. I have no idea what set that came from. I'm not going to look it up. I'm sure somebody in the comment section will, but I don't care about any of these numbers. I don't care about those numbers. I just wanted the detail, and so I have the detail, and there you go. My little brush truck, a small little firefighting truck. Now let's get to the more interesting thing, shall we? Yes, we shall. The hook and ladder, or the tiller ladder truck. This one I really approached wanting to do something different. Once again, just trying to, I wanted, especially for the cab, I did the cab section first, and I just wanted to have something different from anything else that I've done before. Build-wise, I wanted it to be different. So went with a kind of a flat front, but then did add on a little bit of a nose, like some of the, I guess, slightly inspired by some of the newer Pierce apparatus, or Pierce cabs at least. But not trying to be a Pierce replica at all, not trying to be a replica of anything. It's completely made up as I went along. I just started building stuff and really was not trying to replicate anything. Cab only holds one individual in there, does have a driver in it. But the biggest thing is I just wanted the design to be something new as far as how it was built. So all brick and plate built and stuff, and got a couple of cabinets, you know, compartments over here. Did the wheels different front to back. The front wheels are actually really narrow, those narrow little 6 millimeter wide or so, maybe eight millimeter wide ones. And then I do have the, you know, it's a nice short cab. I think originally the cab section or the truck section of it was longer, and I shortened that up as much as I possibly could. And then you get to the trailer section of it, the rear articulated section, the main kind of meat of the whole thing. Of course, you've got your ladder and it's on a turntable, and this one does extend times three. So that part comes out to there, and that part comes out to there, and you can turn it up, and that ends up becoming a fairly tall ladder. As you can see, it's got quite a reach to it, but when you open up a ladder like that, on this type of vehicle, you need to have your support stands. So my support stands can pull out a little bit on either side. And then this gets a little bit tricky, but you can kind of loosen that up, turn these down, close it back, and come on. Work, please. Come on. There we go. And you can do that on both sides. And so you actually have proper supports for either side. And then when you're done, you can contract them in and kind of adjust that, turn it up, and retract them away. So that, I was very lucky that I have those parts. I don't know of any other parts that I can, well, I couldn't find any other parts that could pull off that exact same functionality and hold itself together and fit in the same kind of space and everything. All custom build back here for the kind of the chassis of the trailer section. Oops, that just fell apart. Little bit fragile right there just because I've got four studs that hold all this together and they're not locked together. Just to be able to get the turning motion that I wanted and keeping everything as small as I could. Six wide total and as short as I could to just fit the ladder and the rear, you know, the tiller, the rear cab section, the rear operator section. And everything else was just filling in. You know, basically I made the truck as short as I could, and then I put the ladder down and used that as the base. The ladder plus the rear operator created the length of the entire trailer section, and that's it. You know, one more stud here, not even a half a stud at the back. Actually, it ends right there at the back. So one stud longer than the ladder plus this, really keeping it as small as I can. Because again, as I always say, it is my total. Now that was just from accidentally angling this thing. I get a little bit too rough with it, but my intent with all of my Lego stuff is to keep it as small as I possibly can. I don't care about other people's interest in doing 8 wide vehicles and stuff. I keep my stuff as small as I can so that I can put as much as I can into my Lego city without it looking crowded, without it getting crowded up. A little bit of detail on the back. I do have the ladder for the operator to get in there, and did a little sideways tile on there just to get him a little bit of protection from the side. But you know, it's just the minimum. This one would not have a pump on it. Sometimes, or actually a lot of the time nowadays, this type of apparatus does include a pump. Mine does not include a pump, which just allowed me to make the front again shorter and still make it believable. Everything else is just compartments. I haven't put anything in there, but you know, I just wanted to kind of fill in detail of other space to put stuff. So that's it. That's it for this video. That's it for these two mocks. And like I said, that's it for my fire-related vehicle mocks in general for the time being. I think I'm done with my fire department. I have all the rolling vehicles that I want, as well as a couple of water-based vehicles. I'm not going to do any fire aircraft anytime soon that I can think of. At least I don't have any plans to. And the next thing, like I said, I'll show fire related will be the fire station, and then that will be done and you'll be seeing more other different types of mocks. And I did publish a list of a bunch of stuff, that kind of a summary on my blog a while back, indicating all the stuff that I have planned. So I know I always get repeat requests, Jang, build this, Jang, build this, Jang, build this. And then when I put up something, every time I put something up, somebody says, oh, that was my idea. You did it because I told you to. And that's just not true. I try to stay as creative as possible. And most stuff I announce well in advance of doing it. So you can check out that list. I keep it updated from time to time on my blog to let you know what I have in the queue and what I will be building and what I will be publishing. And I still continue to come up with more surprises, because a lot of this stuff is just based on pure inspiration, which when it comes, I gotta go with it. So that's it. Thank you very much for watching this one, and I'll see you in the next.